Okay, so here we go. The first part of this video, this video is basically going to be to show people, to try and demonstrate the basics, basic methods, basic techniques that you can use when you're doing building. A lot of the other YouTubers who are amazingly talented at this, they do just incredible work, but there aren't many videos that I've found that will show you how to get started. Now me, I'm an intermediate builder, maybe slightly advanced. I can do things, but I'm not very creative as those things go. So the first part of this is going to be to show facing. A lot of my builds, I build for the settlers. I want them to use their environment. I want them to move around naturally, not get hung up on stuff. And one of the things that's a problem is that a lot of objects have specific facing. So when a settler sits down on a stool, they're going to face a certain way, but the stool doesn't show you where the front is. So I told Denise, hi, Phoenix Embrace, hi, Denise, that I would make a video, my first one, this being it, of facing of common objects that I use. Now, this isn't all of them, obviously. These are the ones I know. Brahmin trough is the first one. Brahmin, when they use it, will come from this direction. So when you place it, make sure that the round part's on the left and the faucet's on the right, and they'll approach from this direction. Now, if you have multiple Brahmin, well, they're pretty stupid. They'll come from whatever direction. They don't always use separate troughs, but this is the way you want to place it to make sure they... So figure your Brahmin's going to come at it this way when you stick it down. Give them plenty of room too. They don't path very well. And so if you want your Brahmin to use your troughs, give them plenty of room and place it this way. This bench, the light part, see the front of it here? Here, I'll turn the light on. Nah, it's not good. The dark edge is the back and the light edge is the front. So all these objects here are facing this wall. I am facing the front. Both the ottomans, the visual cue is, you can see how it's kind of rubbed off here. It's not as coarse, plus there's this yellow grunge. I don't even want to know what the hell that is. But that's the back. So both of these are facing front. This stool, the metal stool, all the stools basically, when they're facing forward, it's a leg. A leg will be facing forward, except for these two. So these two stools here have the same top pattern. And the only distinguishing thing is this dark spot is the front, will face front. This stool here, this is the front. So that dark, like, wedge of, you know, pattern right there, that's the left side. So that's about all you get. This little grungy stool here, the only distinguishing feature is that little white smudge right there. That's the front. On this stool here, you really can't tell. Pick whatever you like. That little dark smudge by the leg is probably the best bet. On the baseball stool, I guess just to place it down, there's not really much there to do. And this one here, the bright red spot is sort of towards the back. So that's the front. Now on these three beds, well, the bed, on this one here, it's pretty easy to see. The headboard is slightly higher than the footboard. So that one's not too bad. On this one here, that big triangular stain, that's it. The top of the triangle is the head of the bed. And when they lay down, they'll always face that wall. They'll sleep on their sides. With the sleeping bag, the big bulge at the bottom, that's the bottom. The scrappy rough edge is the top. Doesn't really make much sense because you'd think the pillow part would be where they'd put their heads, but whatever. So that's it. Those are the facings. Now let's go outside here and go over to our tools section. Now for this one, I'm only using the wood part of structures. Okay, and here are the basic tools I will use for everything in this video. We've got the shack bridge, which is in wood miscellaneous, first one there. The concrete, the shack foundation, which is in wood floors. The other shack foundation, wood floors. The ladder, the stairs, which are in wood stairs. The quarter floor, which is in wood floors. The upper roof, again in floors. And my favorite, the post, which is in fences, wire fences, and it's the first post. Okay. Now, these things have properties that let you put them at varying heights. Not the floors, and sort of the post, but not really. But like the ladder, if you click it, you tap A or X, and you can sink it. It'll go down, it'll clip into the floor to a certain level. And it depends on what floor is underneath it. So like you see it hop up here, that's as low as it'll go, but down here it goes way low. Okay, and it stays green, or in my case, aqua. That means you can place it. Same thing with this floor, it sinks to a degree. And this one does, and this one does. The reason I use the shack, the bridge for stuff is because I can see around it. I don't really get a lot of good camera angles. So one of the things that this is really good for as part of a feature is the doors. So here we are in Sunshine. Everybody knows this place, and you know he's got these little cabins, and the cabins don't have doors. So you go to place a door, you're like, I want to put a door here. Yeah, except it doesn't work because the game does not recognize that as a valid doorway. One of the things about doors is doors have to go in a door frame to operate. The game knows that they have to be placed in a door frame. So let's put up a door frame. Wood, walls, door. There's the doorway. So, okay, you got your doorway, and where did I put the doors? Okay, I'm going to be stumbling around these a lot, so bear with me. So there's your door, and you're like, okay, good. I got a door. The door works. Sweet. Let me close the door here. All right. So then you're like, I'm going to put the door with the frame, because I need the door frame, right? I need it. Where are you going, dude? I need the door frame. So what you do is you press and hold your pickup key. For Xbox, it's A. For PS4, it's X. And you go, all right, I'm going to go put this thing in here. But it doesn't work. Well, that's not the right one anyway. That's why it doesn't work. So we'll go over here. But the game recognizes that building is solid. It will not let you put the door frame in the door. Yeah, I can't put the door there. Now, two things here. One, the group select feature allows you to select one object, one element, whether it be the door frame, the door, a post, a floor, whatever. And then it also lets you select everything that particular item is close enough to, including everything attached to whatever that thing is close to. So you can pick up amazingly huge structures as long as everything's built together. So what do we do with this? Well, what you can do is you take the shack wall and the doorway. You need the doorway to build a door, but you don't need the doorway to keep the door. You could store the doorway in the workshop. So then what you do is you go take your post. I like this post because it's easy to see around. And you put it close to the door. As soon as it touches, it'll turn red. So okay, that's close. Set it down. And then the post, you press and hold X or A, and now you have your door. So then you take your door, la-di-di-di-da. You go over here, if I can get up on the porch, and it'll fit. And you go, voila. Kind of ease it in there, look for the edges, make sure it fits in there just right, set it down, and voila, working door. But you're like, oh, wait, that door's way too high, man. That is totally not going to work. Okay, so now we go to the second part of our basic tool set, and we move this over here. Let's come back over here. Let's take the door out. Put them down here. Okay, now we go get one of our pieces that we know will sink into the ground. In this case, let's just take the ladder. It's easier. Again, because it's easier to see around. So you put the ladder close to the door. I don't know if this is going to work. I've never tried this. And come on. Come on. You know you want to. That's probably not close enough. No, it's not. Okay. We're not going to use that one. The ladder's not going to work. Let's use our bridge. The bridge gets really close to the door, right? Now you can see the door is still kind of hanging off. Still, there's still light under it. So what you do is you do the same thing. Press and hold A, press and hold X. Group select. Now, the trick here is this. The object you select, you press and hold on, controls the properties of the group. So in this case, if you press and hold A or X, and then you press and hold your left shoulder button, LB for Xbox, or I guess it's L1 for PlayStation, and you wait a second, because you'll move around if you don't, you can drop the door down into the ground. I mean, you can make a half door if you want to. But the key is you watch it and it clips in the ground, boom. Put the bridge back. Multi-step processes are so much fun. Grab your posts. Now your door's low and you put your post there. And I just put it a little bit higher. Grab your door. Oh, come on, don't be like that. Okay, now you'll see the door is red. That means there's a problem with how the game perceives you picking up this post. That's gonna be hard to place. So we need to move the post somewhere else, probably here. Still red. Why are you still red? Oh, because the door's in the ground. Let's see if it'll work anyway. In for a penny, in for a pound. Yeah, here it is. I don't think it's gonna work. No. Okay, so that's not gonna work. Let's see if we can't. Why is that not working? That should work. Let's move this back over here. Let's lift it just a little bit. A lot of stuff is trial and error. Okay, now it's not, there it goes. Now it's let me lift it. Put the door back. And voila. Come on. Okay, see, now it's green. So the problem was the door was in the ground and the game said, okay, you can't put a door in the ground. It won't work. Then you put the door back in here and... okay, so it's not perfect, but it's better. You get the idea. So with a little bit of practice, you can totally put doors or anything anywhere you want to. The trick is building something, taking stuff away that you don't want, and putting it back. Now, the other thing I wanted to show you for this abbreviated video is a very, very basic shop. A lot of builders like to do very grand, huge, amazing thematics, you know, towns and cities and oh my God, blah, blah. I'm not good enough for that. I don't really do well with large buildings and large structures like that. I like to build small things, basic things that my settlers can use. So let's build a small basic shop. Now this is only going to be for a level 1 or a level 2 shop. Level 3 shops are way too big for this. And this is where I'm going to show how to do modular things using this little floor, which I like a lot. I like the little floors because you can snap almost anything to them and they play nice with almost everything in the wood tab. So let's go get ourselves a wall. Now, they say walls, but a lot of these walls come with floors, like this. So here's the front of your shop. Let's just put this down. And then we'll pick, let's say this one for the bag. Put it on the back, and boom. Oh, come on, you know you want to. So right there is a framework for a basic one-person hut. It's a little shack, it's a shed, you can use a storage shed. All kinds of uses you can do with this basic structure. And since you can use any wall, you can customize it any way you want to. There's all kinds of things you can do with this. Now, to make a shop, generally speaking, the only two pieces that really work with these walls are the, that are designed to work with these walls, are the ones way down here at the end, the little half walls. This little one here snaps like that, and it snaps like that. So if you want to do a shed, you can just do like this, and, you know, do the group select, put a door here, and then just fill it with stuff. Kind of cool, whatever. But I want to make a shop. I want to make it open. I want to make it airy, sort of. So I want to put one of those little half walls, the ones over here, these little half walls here, the balcony railings, right? But they don't clip to these walls. It doesn't let you clip them to the wall. It doesn't like that. Okay, so in this one here, I'm gonna put the shop on this half. It's gonna be on this side. So I want a little railing right here, and this will be the entrance so the vendor can see out. Actually, let's move this. Group select, put it over here. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so now we got this. What you do, put this in the workshop, take your quarter floor, snap it here. Then, snap your railing here, take the floor out. The railing stays. Go back to your walls, get your vendor window there, and boom. Now you've got a railing, so the vendor can see out sideways. And you can put another one here if you wanted to, or put four of them all the way around, make a balcony out of it, whatever. Same thing with the stairs. Well, in this case, let's use this little ladder since I already have it out. The ladder will not clip. So the vendor can't actually get into his own house. He can't get into a shop because they don't jump. They won't hop up. Same deal. Put the ladder back, move this out of the way. Grab your wood shack floor, snap it there. Grab your ladder, snap it there. Move the floor and oh man, don't call me a liar now. Come on. Oh geez, seriously? Wow. And there you go, ladder. You can use any ladder, any stairway, anything that'll clip to this little piece, that wall will let you do. So now you come up in here. I guess for the walls, we can just put those, where the hell is it? We'll just stick those walls back up here. So now you've got a little building. You can use the same trick to put another platform in front of this. You know, just take this off, put your floor down, put another floor in front of it, take that back floor out, snap this back, and it'll go back. The key is to make sure it'll snap back before you take it off. Like, take it off and then try and put it back, and if it snaps, you're good. And that's it. Little vendor shop. Now, to put the actual vendor in there requires another technique. This is called the rug glitch. It's been called the rug glitch since I first heard about it. And it works a lot the same as the group select, except you don't have to hold, you just pick up. So let's go do this. Let's go find ourselves a rug. Oh, rugs, rugs, rugs. We love you so much. Get a little rug. We'll get two for this thing. The reason I took two is you can look and you can see how the rug kind of sticks out, sort of elevated. So you know when your shop's on top of it. So let's go get a shop. Where is it? In stores. Let's make a bar because everybody loves bars. Where is it? Hang on, I gotta eat here. Survival mode, so. This is weird. The bar's not showing up. There it is. Maybe it wasn't showing because I wasn't eating. So this is a fun one. The two bar works really good here. So, okay, the key is it's on the ground right now, right? See how it's on the ground? It's moving around. It's going up and down. But if you watch, when you put it on the rug, let's turn it around like this. Do those like this. It hops. See how it jumped? Now that it's jumped, it's on the rug. Even though it doesn't look like it, the game thinks it is. So we set it down, and then we pick up the rug. You don't press and hold, you just click. And voila. Now we can place this wherever the rug will fit. The game doesn't pay attention to anything else except that rug. So you can push this thing through walls, you can stick it on ceiling, you can put it anywhere you like. As long as that rug turns green, it'll fit. So let's push it through here. And that's good. Click, and there it is. You've seen this a million times in other videos. Adipose TV has a really good series on the rug glitch and group select. I'll link that in the description. It's really thorough if you really want to understand how this thing works. And what, okay, so the trick is when you take the rugs out, this is going to drop to the surface below it. So I'm not going to take it out. I usually leave my rugs in, but that's it. So now you've got a little settle, you've got a little shop. Now to add extra flavor, if you'd like, you can put something in this hole using the rugs as well. I've been favoring cabinets lately because they fill the space so nicely. But weapon racks will fit there. Just anything will fit there, really. So let's do this again. Floor covering, rug, and then containers. Let's get that big cabinet. Howdy, neighbor. So what I do on these is I put it backwards. Pop. Okay, put it backwards so that I can see it from the front. The disadvantage of this is I can't see the rug from the back, right? But I just keep clicking until it drops. And you push it through. And come on, come on. I want it as far forward as I can. But I don't want those handles showing through. So we do like that. And there you go. Now your vendor's got some shelves they can use. So, yeah, it's a multifunctional, modifiable, customizable thing. So if you're new to building and you want a little visual variety, but you don't want to sit there all day playing with stuff, two or three of these in various configurations scattered around will do pretty amazing. It'll look good. It won't look, you know, advanced and whatever, but it'll be better than a big box with the same old walls and, you know, a bunch of bed slab down in it. I guess that's about it for this one. I can't really think of anything else I want to say, and I'm sort of tapped out. Maybe in future ones I'll do, you know, bigger buildings or whatever, but I like to do modular things, you know, things I can customize and that are easy to modify, but that are the same basic thing. Any suggestions, comments, questions, let me know in the comments below. Give me a like if you like this. I'm just trying to do things that I know how to do that aren't beyond my skill level. And I guess that'll do it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.